Hello guys, and welcome to another flight review of mine. I'm now in Newcastle, New South Wales. I'm about to fly Link Airways Saab 340 aircraft to Canberra, ACT. Let's head to the airport now. Newcastle is the second most populated city in New South Wales, a two-hour drive north of Sydney. The city is surrounded by golden sand beaches, a breathtaking coastline, and a beautiful working harbour. The Newcastle Light Rail opened on the 17th of February 2019, running from Newcastle Interchange, which connects with trains to Sydney, through the Central Business District to Pacific Park. A total distance of 2.7 kilometres and 6 stops. The light rail is the first entirely wire-free system in Australia. The unique approach uses an onboard power supply and provides charging at stations while waiting for passengers to board and disembark through a connection to an elevated charge bar at each stop. Now let's head to the airport before I get soaked in the rain. The rain started pouring down while I was on the bus to the airport, but it certainly wasn't as bad as what Newcastle encountered in late March. Oh, that lightning was really frightening. Newcastle Airport is situated 15 kilometers north of Newcastle. It has regular flights to Sydney, Brisbane, Melbourne, as well as destinations in regional New South Wales. I arrived at the airport 2 hours before the scheduled departure time, but it turns out that Link Airways check-in desk does not open until an hour before departure. So don't come to the airport too early. Lucky that I didn't arrive 3 hours in advance.
Hello.
Cameras,
yes, please.
Any check luggage?
Oh, yes, two beds.
So, your name is your boarding pass, a pay version. If you're speaking in your name, we're boarding around 5 o'clock today.
Cool, thank you.
Thank you.
The terminal's departure lounge provides several workstations and plenty of seating space. There's a cafe and a mini food court in case you are hungry. Newcastle Airport was indeed an international airport. Before COVID-19, Virgin Australia had direct flights to Auckland, New Zealand. On the other side of the runway is Royal Australian Air Force Base Williamstown. From the terminal, you can see some cool military aircraft. The aircraft that will be taking me to Canberra today is the Link Airways Saab 340B Plus aircraft. Link Airways, formerly known as Fly Corporate, operates scheduled regional passenger services from Queensland to regional New South Wales, Wollongong to Melbourne, and most recently, Canberra to Newcastle and Canberra to Hobart. As of April 2019, the airline has a fleet of 5 Saab 340B and 3 Fairchild Metro 23. I flew on one of the Metro 23 from Narrabri to Sydney in December 2020. I had an excellent flight. That's why I'm flying with them again today and eager to experience Link Airways hospitality on board their larger Saab 340 aircraft. While waiting to board my flight, a Jetstar Airbus A320 from Melbourne just landed at the airport and decided to park in front of me. It's really cool to see the aircraft from such a close distance, and the engine sound is amazing.
This is information for all passengers traveling to Canberra on Link Airways flight SC208. The aircraft is now
boarding for gate
1.
98, so easy.
So just out to the high vis.
Yeah. Right there.
Yeah,
flight, you're like, oh, crap.
Yeah.
Hello.
The Saab 340 is a Swedish-built twin-engine turboprop. The seats on Link Airways Saab 340 are in a 2-1 configuration with a total of 34 seats. Due to the size of the fuselage, only one side of the aircraft has overhead luggage bin. The 2-1 configuration is really awesome. It satisfies both single travelers and couples. I can't find the exact seat specs on the internet, but I think it has a width of 18.5 inches and a pitch of 13 inches. The seat has high back seating and is reclinable. I reckon this is one of the most comfortable seats on a turboprop aircraft. Today I picked seat 9A. It has a good view of the propeller, the landing gear, and the scenery outside the window is not blocked by the wing.
It's my absolute pleasure to welcome you on board your Link Airways service through to Canberra. Our flight time tonight is approximately 1 hour. If there is anything that we can do to make your flight more comfortable, please don't hesitate to let me know. Use these ones for our own flight. I now invite you to sit back and relax while we prepare the cabin for departure. Thank you. Welcome aboard once again, ladies and gentlemen. May I please have your attention for a few moments while I demonstrate the safety features of our Saab 340 aircraft. By now, your seatbelt should be firmly fastened. To tighten, pull on the strap, and to release, lift the buckle.
Above each seat, there's an individually controlled air vent and a reading light. At the back of each seat, there's a massive tray table with two cup holders. In the seat pocket, there's a safety card and a Link Airways Inflight magazine, updated every 2 months. It includes attractions in the places that Link flies to and a map of its latest network. The Canberra to Newcastle route was added to its network in November 2020. Now let's have a look at the in-flight meal service, which has totally surprised me. In terms of the drink options, there are 4 types of wines for you to choose from. 1 Sauvignon Blanc, 1 Chardonnay, 1 Merlot and 1 Shiraz. On top of that, there are 2 types of fresh juice, tea and coffee. In terms of the snacks, Link provides a pack of cheese and crackers. Yes, in addition, there's a pack of mixed nuts. These snacks are certainly healthier than the soil mix that Virgin and Qantas offer in the air snack box. I'm already pretty happy with what Link offers on such a short flight. But if you are still hungry, they also have chips. What's more, there are 4 different flavors for you to choose from. Link is certainly a very thoughtful airline that provides different options to satisfy the need of each passenger. Well, at least I am impressed. After flying through some clouds, we are now above Sydney. Can you see the Sydney Opera House and Bondi Beach? The city looks so beautiful from above, even on a cloudy day. This is Botany Bay. Can you see Sydney Airport's runway 34 right? This is what the nut mix looks like. And oh, the cabin crew also gave each of us a bottle of water. Maybe that's why the tray table has two cup holders instead of one. Let's try the cheese crackers. I love cheese. While we fly over Wollongong, the cloud again disappeared, which gave me a 10-second window to admire this beautiful city located in the Illawarra region. The lady sat next to me asked for a second glass of white wine. I also took this opportunity to try their Shiraz. Before landing, we were offered some mints to freshen our breath. Now let's check out the lavatory on board. The lavatory on this Saab 340B is located at the front of the cabin. It is very tiny and there's no water for you to wash your hand. Link provides alcohol wipes, but my suggestion is avoid using this toilet unless it's an emergency. The 1 hour flight to Canberra passed quickly. The scenery outside also changes constantly. They are very stunning. The flight overall was truly extraordinary. Although the weather was bad in Newcastle, the whole flight was quite smooth. The highlight was no doubt the onboard service. The cabin crew was very nice, and the amount of snack and beverage options that Link offers is truly amazing. I would give this experience a 10 out of 10. This is my first time ever given a 10 out of 10 in my flight reviews. I have been thinking very hard, but I can't really fault anything throughout my whole journey. I think Link Airways well deserves this 10 out of 10 from me. Fly Pelican also operates several flights per day between Newcastle and Canberra. Both airlines charge $149 on this route. But without a cabin crew, I don't think the experience with Fly Pelican would be as good as this one. I will try Fly Pelican one day when I get a chance. We are about to land on runway 30. This is the shorter runway out of the two runways at Canberra Airport. It's mainly used by general aviation. I feel very lucky to land on this runway for the first time. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you have never flown with Link Airways before, I recommend you to give them a go. If you like this video, please don't forget to hit the like button for me and subscribe to my channel for more exciting and honest train and flight reviews from me. I'll see you guys in my next video.